I feel like, should we take advantage?
Yeah, we'll actually start.
Like, let's do some deep breathing exercises. Okay. It's breathing time. Sometimes you have to take things literally. All right. Just follow my lead.
Yes. Yeah.
It's going to be like, it's going to be ASMR. I'm going to bring the mic closer to my mouth.
Yeah, Zaid will lead us in.
And now, breathe deeply. Follow the sounds of my voice. You will be transported to a dimension not very different from the one that you're used to. But it will be filled with peace and harmony. In 5 seconds, you will breathe in and hold for 5 seconds. Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, that's what I like.
There we go.
Damn, I'm awake.
Welcome back
to the 2 a.m. podcast.
Well,
we still got
it's time. A collab.
We do have time.
Let's go. Yeah, keep it going.
We still got time, bro.
Yeah, next time we got to get Z on this. He said, what?
I thought he was going to be on, bro. I thought he was going to be on.
Yeah, I literally didn't see your text until.
Damn it. He's prepared for next time now.
Oh, now he
knows. Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, Z.
You get to see how we roll.
Yeah, for sure, bro. He should be on the show right now. 2 a.m.
he's got concepts.
Oh, yeah. Dude, my bad. I don't know why everyone jumps to that fucking, you know, that question right there.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah,
also, just as a note.
First of all,
fantastic what?
Play on the water.
Just literally, when I was like, why the fuck?
Position.
I would usually don't, take the
blame for this, but that was your fault.
That's why you got the backup cup, bro. That's why you got the backup cup.
It's all.
I did get a backup cup.
Yeah, we have a backup if you want it.
Here. No, I don't need the water. I want to do. I dry the carpet or.
Oh, dude.
It's. Don't worry. I mean, it's water. I just cleaned your carpet.
You actually kind of did. Look.
It's all good. It's
like
all
we
good.
Vacuum in this bitch, but like we should get a shampoo in there.
Mm-hmm.
Probably be a nice thing to do.
Steam vacuum.
Steam vacuum.
What's your favorite shampoo?
My favorite shampoo, dude, actually there's this, tea tree oil, jojoba and tea tree oil.
Really?
Is it by
shampoo?
Paul Mitchell?
No, it's not by Paul Mitchell. It's by, it's one, honestly, to tell you the truth, it's like, you can find it at all those stores where you like walk in and you can like smell earth, you know, like Sprouts or, you know, like all of those types of grocery stores. Anywhere where you walk
earth.
In, you're like,
just
yeah.
Walk in, you're like, it's earth in
you're
here,
like,
baby.
And yes. It's the type of place that you want to Instagram and like post, like, not at McDonald's, you know, like,
yeah.
I'm,
oh
you know,
God.
Health grind 2022, and it's like, it's fucking April. Like, what do you mean?
Yeah, I'm pro fit.
Over here, like,
yeah, literally. It's not April, actually. It's May.
I know, you're right.
Halfway through the year, dude.
That's crazy.
That's absurd.
My lease is almost up.
You what? Your lease is almost up? Is that what you said?
I don't know. It's like, it seems like a 2-year thing, right?
Put that shit on auto pay and then squatter rights, baby.
Yeah, you're good to go.
COVID relief.
we need to hang out more.
Wait for those stimmies to hit, bro. It's got you.
You know what I'm
worry.
Saying? Just say, hey,
you.
Yeah,
got
no
you.
Worries. I'm moving out. And just leave your shit there.
People
do that, bro.
That's
there are mad landlords. Like people I've been having conversations with recently who are like, yo, what do I do? Call the cops on a family that like can't afford to pay rent?
No, for real. That was a good question. Like throughout COVID, it's like, what the fuck do they do? Like how many unemployment was at like 14-16%?
It depends on the landlord, bro.
Like what are people going to do if they don't got the money for that shit?
You could be the type of landlord that you should be, which, you know, hopefully is all of our goals eventually.
Yeah.
You got to buy real estate, obviously. But
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like you can be two types of landlords. One is the all business, no compassion type landlord. And two is the one who's actually like doing it for the benefit of others, you know, in a lot of ways, like being a landlord could be mutually beneficial.
Yeah. 100%.
Right. Like you can benefit yourself and benefit people because you're giving them a place to live that's clean. You're maintaining it. You know what I'm saying? It's easier for them to access than buying a house.
Yeah.
So there are good things, but like there are good ways to do it. I've seen, you know, like
well,
people do
yeah,
it properly.
Yeah. There are very negative things that do like that are being pushed right now about like buying or owning land.
Correct.
In general.
What are you talking about?
Well, right now it's a super buyer's market.
Thank
so things
you.
Are super
yeah, things
super
are expensive.
Expensive. But that's because
right
they gave lower interest rates.
Mm.
When you get a lower interest rate, your budget goes up. So if you were going to buy a $500,000 house, your interest rate's low enough now that maybe it's a $600,000 house.
Yeah.
So there are more options.
It's true.
Supply and demand, baby.
It's crazy.
Economics, yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm just going to hit buzzwords for the rest of the duration of this podcast.
We can all agree.
Like, I'm hitting the estate you know? Tax.
I'm going to be like one of those guys. I'm going to be one of those guys that puts like business insight in my IG bio. You know what I mean?
Ooh.
With like three emojis. Like yeah. DM to hire me now.
Right. Crypto advice once and it worked out kind of okay. You're like business. That's
yes.
me.
Business. Sales. Financial I am advisor. A business.
Stonks.
Stonks. Cryptos with an S at the end. When people say cryptos, I always laugh.
Cryptos.
Oh, I
invested in multiple cryptos.
I'm like, yes. With an S?
NFTs.
Yes.
What about them?
Have you thought of making one?
Or selling one?
Yeah.
Dude, okay. Hold on.
Yeah, Phyllis.
Do we want to go through the, do we want to go for my hoodie on?
Yeah, yeah, I want to go cozy. I want to blast off right now.
No, but like, okay. Here's the thing about NFTs. Like, the first wave is dead. In my opinion, right? It was a cool hype thing. It was very short lived, but that's because of how fast it grew, it also died that fast.
Yeah, it lasted around like what, a week, 2 weeks?
Maybe a little longer than that. Yeah. I mean, people have been talking. I mean, people were playing in NFTs in 2017, 2016.
Hmm.
You know
really?
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was happening.
Oh, shit.
Like,
I didn't even know
people
about that.
That, like, excuse me, people that are like, you know, I think the generation right before us that are still like extremely. Kind of ingrained in what life is like for our generation.
Yeah.
You know, like that understand technology, understand like the development of business and like new potential revenue streams and things like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like those guys are the ones who were playing in crypto and playing in you know, NFT space and stuff like years
ago. Definitely. 100%.
You know what I'm saying?
Like all the Bitcoin billionaires that are, or millionaires that are fucking teenagers, you know, like 18.
Exactly.
It's like, when'd you buy that shit? When you were six? Like,
yeah. Yeah. Well, that's a different case. But what I'm talking about is like the 40-year-olds
now.
You know
what
I'm saying?
What you mean. Yeah.
The 40-year-olds right now that are like, that know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. I'm picking up what you're putting down.
And when you sit and have a conversation with them, you're just like, damn, this is like, you know? Like, yeah, I came from this. I was born in the technology kind of era, the technology revolution. I had a cell phone when I was young, things like that, you know? But you still know a lot more about it than I do, you know? And that wisdom, I think, comes with just
in a sense,
time. You know what I mean?
I can see it.
Yeah, definitely.
I can see it. Like, I think they're not equally, like...
Ingrained? No, they're not. But if you team up with them, like... Mm-hmm. Me and knowing what I know and having the skill set that I have and having your wisdom and like know-how.
Dude, you're forming the X-Men.
And connections.
Like, yeah,
like, yeah, yeah. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay,
facts.
Okay. Got you.
Shout out Kai. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? For real, dude. It's dope.
Bro, we got a fan.
I like that.
Here.
That's very interesting.
It's cool, man.
It's all about
But NFTs anyway, to kind of touch back on that real quick. Like the hype died, but what's happening now is the real artists and the real use applications of them are going to emerge.
Gotcha.
Right? This is what always happens.
Yeah.
What is the real use application?
Eventually.
Because I've been still trying to figure this out from a an investment standpoint. Like, is it worth...
Do you understand what it
I get
fundamentally
like,
is?
I kind of do, but I disagree, at least from my understanding of what it fundamentally is, because it doesn't make sense.
Let me ask you, like, I'm going to take a play from, like, I forgot where I heard this, but somebody said
this. All right, go for it.
Have you ever played Fortnite?
Yeah, I played Fortnite.
Unfortunately.
Did you buy skins?
No.
Never?
Never won.
Did you know how successful the skin store was?
Unbelievably so.
Those are NFTs. Because that is a digital asset you own, you pay real money for, and you own exclusively in that universe. You can't use it anywhere else. That's the beginning of an NFT.
Okay, that makes more sense.
That's the foundation of
an NFT. That actually unlocks a whole new set of knowledge for me.
So now imagine if that skin could be used when you're taking an IG picture as an AR filter and you're wearing that object.
Okay.
Or imagine the potential use cases are infinite because it is an authenticated, non-fungible token, NFT, authenticated item, digital asset, right? That has intrinsic value based on what the market is doing around it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But also serves a purpose, whatever that purpose may be. Like, it is the equivalent of a certificate of authenticity to the Mona Lisa that the Louvre has. Like, the Louvre Museum in France owns the Mona Lisa.
Yes.
That is a physical asset,
mm-hmm.
okay? So imagine if the Mona Lisa was a digital painting rather than a physical painting. How do you certify its authenticity? NFTs.
But doesn't that essentially ruin the value of it if it's... repeated multiple times?
Not necessarily.
How?
Because Michael Jordan X Off-White sneakers, they released 10,000 pairs.
Yeah.
Their resale value is a lot higher than pairs that are available at Foot Locker.
That's true.
You see what I'm saying?
But
scarcity and demand, it's a supply and demand thing. So this is the first time you've been able to produce, I mean, not really the first time, but the first time you've been able to produce art, but instead of it just being one Mona Lisa, a lot of people can have Mona Lisas. Yeah, it's not going to be I don't know how much is the Mona Lisa worth. I don't
priceless.
Know. Right. Like, yeah. 300 price, million. I don't know. You can't
put a price tag on that.
Like something like that, you know? But like, this is the first time you've been able to like divvy that up and make it individual kind of. The way that they do it right now is they'll like do limited releases, or they have some that are kind of minted as soon as you purchase them. So as soon as you purchase it, mm-hmm. it authenticates that you bought it from the source and you now own a digital work by so-and-so artist. So right now NFTs are being used for art mainly, digital art, but that's not the end result.
So let me ask you this, right? Because I'm sorry, I still need to understand NFTs because a lot of it doesn't make sense to me, right? Sure. And when I ask different people about certain things pertaining to them, I get mm-hmm. different answers.
Let me tell you something though, just as a warning.
Yeah,
We're all still learning about this.
Okay.
There are people who know way more than me.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I've just been an artist for a lot of my life, I feel like, and mm-hmm. just, you know, all about the arts. So now, because of that, I found myself very interested and kind of ingrained in it as soon as I started hearing about it, which was like early last year, like barely. There were really no established like interfaces for them the way that they are now.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Mm. Or maybe they existed. I don't know if Rarible or whatever existed then, but like I never saw it.
It was mainly just the ownership.
Yeah.
That I had a problem with, because when you buy the NFT, you're not necessarily buying the ownership or the rights to the painting, because that's what I originally thought it was. Like, for example, who was that one guy? He makes like one digital piece of art every single day. Beeple.
Mm-hmm.
He made an NFT and it had like 1,000 of his artworks mm-hmm. included in this one PNG or JPEG, whatever file it was, right?
$69 million.
Crazy amount of money.
Right.
Stupid.
But that was also about the news and about being able to make the news.
True.
That's how they gain their value.
That is also true.
There's a social element.
But the person who bought that, they don't own the Beeple painting, from my understanding. They own the rights to the NFT, which is subscribed to the painting.
Correct.
However, if Beeple wanted to go sell his painting again, he has all the rights to do so.
Correct.
Which essentially begs the question, why the NFT?
Because the NFT is a new painting.
But what does that hold value, though?
It's its own painting. The NFT is its own. Imagine instead of it making...
But he could sell the same painting.
He could, but he's not going to. That's the whole point. He only minted one. If he mints another one, it's not authentic like the first one, because the whole message behind that painting is there's only one.
No, I'm saying he could sell the original painting because
it's still his work. The physical painting that's on his wall.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine, because that's not the painting.
But that is the painting.
No, there's a representation of that painting in this new painting. So imagine instead of him making that in Photoshop or whatever, he physically painted a painting that showed 1,000 of his paintings.
So you're considering the NFT as a separate entity from the original piece
of art? It's its own piece. It's its own. It holds its own weight as a piece. That image, that single JPEG file, holds its own weight as a piece, the same way his painting on the wall holds. It's just a different mechanism to create it. Instead of painting it with paint, he did it in Photoshop.
So let me ask you a question. What would you rather have?
Both.
There you go.
And NFTs are going to become a vessel for you to be able to do things like that. There's this dude, Zaptio, that like followed me on Instagram randomly, and I clicked on him and I was watching him. I think I might have actually followed him a while ago, but I wasn't really like paying attention to what was going on.
Yeah.
He has a studio called Artifact Studio, RTFKT Studio. Bro, sick. Like, these guys have been making NFT sneakers, right? And you're asking about the use application. I can't do anything with that yet. But the people who are buying these things, the people who are on this, understand that they will be able to. There will be use application for these, and these are all assets. Do you see what I'm saying?
You know what? The only thing that it would make sense for me, because maybe in a world where we can't actually physically handle these files, like it doesn't.
But let me
make
tell you what they're doing.
But if we go to virtual,
yes,
like if you go to VR,
which is coming at the end of this year,
yeah,
that makes sense.
It's right. Yeah,
exactly.
That's what it's for.
Yeah. Okay, that makes
it's,
a,
it's
that
for
makes
the metaverse,
way
dude.
More sense.
It's for the next generation of lifestyle.
Yeah.
So Ready Player One on
there
crack.
There you go.
So
see how that
life.
Just shifted your perspective?
That makes that way just, more sense.
It's exactly what you always
I have
about.
I have two points to make
they
here.
Are
one
flex.
Of them's a question, actually.
All right, yeah.
Yeah, they're a flex. Right now, they're a flex. Like, yeah. Yo, I got these artifacts.
You had a painting on your wall, right?
Yeah.
And everyone's like, oh, shit, this guy has $100 million painting. But if I pull out my phone and I can pull out a file that has $4 billion worth of art, like, your painting in your house is going to mean nothing. Because I can hold mine and show mine on my phone.
Okay, but here's the thing. Well, just to touch on what Zaptio and Artifact Studios are doing. They basically have done a release now with Jeff Staple, who made this is by Jeff Staple actually.
Super dope, by the way. Shout out to Jeff Staple.
Yeah, I mean he's super sick. You know, he's in a lot of ways an OG in this game. But like he has the Staple Pigeon Dunks, which are like, you know, super sought after sneakers that are like $45,000 right now.
Dang.
A pair. They came out in like 2009, I think. I'm not really sure when.
Fresh is all I'm hearing.
Yeah. Well, no, they're cool, but like it's all but there's like a lot of hype around them, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, he released an NFT with Artifact Studios, and then they also sent you the physical sneaker when you bought it.
Mm. Okay, that's different.
No, but here's the thing.
I can get behind that.
Now that sneaker you know is authentic because there's a QR code probably on that sneaker that you can scan, and it checks the blockchain to make sure that this is real. So you don't need StockX anymore. You don't need some guy. You don't need to trust. StockX sends fake shoes all the time. I apologize for anybody who's a fan of StockX.
No, they do.
Yeah, but like,
I've worked with StockX.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, I bought some fake shit from StockX.
Yeah. No. Don't. Yeah. This fool probably went to Chinatown, bought some fake shit, and came back. He's like, oh, StockX, bro.
It's actually a pair of one of these.
Oh,
really? Ultra Boosts?
It was a pair of UB3s because I don't like the newer generations. These still have way softer boost. So I bought a pair, and they came in, and like the continental rubber part on the bottom, it was already peeling off. Like, and you were looking around, and it was like, some of this shit don't look right, bro.
I'll
like, there was
pissed.
Weird holes, like, up here, like, for
He's like,
for
does breathing. That say Ultra Boast?
Ultra Bust.
Yeah.
It's a braggadacious pair of shoes right
That's
here.
Crazy. No, but what I was...
whole community now that are, like, all about the fake shit, bro.
Oh, dude, for
Reps,
real.
Reps is the
what do you mean?
Shoes-wise, people, like, literally full-time believe that.
Oh, like, fuck
no,
the
for real, dude. The ultimate example of that is YeezyTrainer.com. You buy a fake pair of
Wait,
Yeezy.
Wait, hold on.
I'm not even fucking with
okay,
you.
Okay, so you pulled that out real quick, bro.
Yeah.
You've been on there.
I have been on there. You want to know why? Because this motherfucker I'm friends with, he bought a pair because he thought he was going to buy a real one, got the fake ones that came in, and he was like, I wear them out and people don't even know that they're, you know, not real. So why does it matter?
I could probably tell you.
And on top, well... I know what you're about to say.
I'm not even a Yeezy fanboy like
Neither
that. I mean,
I
like some sneakers, but I could definitely
keep in mind.
They're like 11 checkpoints.
This was like
that they should be doing at StockX
4-ish years ago.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah,
gotcha.
And these aren't meant to be real Yeezys. Yeah. These are like purpose built. Like they look real enough. Like
Feezies.
You know, if you're in a bar, Feezies.
Yeah, Feezies.
Bro,
yeah.
Drinking Fiji and the Feezies, son.
Fiji and the Feezies. And then this boy has a Fiji bottle he's been refilling from the tap. Oh, posted God. Fiji and the Feezies.
Bro.
Fiji and the Feezies. That's funny, bro. See what's
NFT. Perfect.
Drinking Arrowhead out of the Fiji bottle? That's funny. Wait,
oh,
imagine drinking Fiji out of the Arrowhead bottle. That's the kind of person I want to hang out
no,
with.
No, dude, that's actually...
You know what I'm saying?
You know what that is, bro?
That's a humble person.
That's stealth wealth. That's,
stealth wealth.
Bro, that's the guy that goes to like his favorite taco truck to get coffee in the morning, and then he's just got that little styrofoam cup instead of going to Starbucks. That's stealth wealth, right?
Mm-hmm.
But he brought his...
But he made
like
it with a Breville.
Taco truck.
He made it with a Breville.
Like, you know, where you get like a breakfast burrito in the morning or some shit like that?
Shit.
Dude, they're fire. You should definitely hit some up. Like, the ones in L.A. and around here especially are low-key better than a lot of restaurants. I'm not even fucking with you because these people, they're super talented, but they don't have the money to, like, afford a storefront. So they just buy a giant taco truck or, like, a van or something like that, and then they cook out of there.
Like, I mean, 9 times out of 10, for sure, tacos trucks are better than taco restaurants.
Have you ever had,
But
like,
there's some fire taco restaurants.
Talk about
a shout out Taco Bell for
been
life.
Different since the
talk about sponsoring me immediately.
Hitting different since the 80s, bro.
No, but I feel you. That guy comes up. He has a coffee machine. It's a coffee cup, but he made it at home. That's,
no, bro,
that dude's dope.
Dude definitely has an espresso machine at home.
Breville,
but he's like,
bro. Breville barista touch. That's what I'm trying to get.
But it's like this dude's like the foreman on some fucking work site, you know? And he's like, I don't want to flex on all these dudes bringing my expensive ass coffee. I'll bring in my.
Just hang out with the people, bro.
Little styrofoam.
I don't care
bro.
How many NFTs you sell. You should always be from the people. Remember where you came from,
no,
Beeple?
Of course, bro.
I'm just playing.
Beeple?
Beeple's tight. He knows where he came from.
No, Beeple
for sure.
Knows what's up. Man.
Yeah, he definitely knows what's up.
He makes
up,
dope
but, like,
shit.
So dude, I have a question for you, actually.
Mm-hmm. No.
Like, talk me through how the hell you would find out the checkpoints for checking shoes.
Me?
Yeah, like
how would
I
know that?
Because I
just
started
like years
examining.
Of being a nerd and researching shit.
Dude, yeah, probably. that's really what it comes down to.
Yeah, I've just been like, you know, collecting
so literally years
for a while.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. That's
I mean,
a huge
you know
thing.
What's funny? You know what's funny is like I don't remember the last time I did that, right? Like I just have like my three dudes that I talk to when I need sneakers and that's it, you know? But like
a couple years ago when I was an Adidas boy. I liked, you know, I like three stripes.
Until I came in.
Not at all. And so, like, I was really good at identifying, like, fake UBs when these were fucking big back in the day and, like, Yeezys and shit like that. Mm-hmm. I can't do any of that now. I don't got the time for that shit. But,
yeah,
like,
they're different, bro. I think it's changed. How do you, like, you know those, like, Yeezys?
They change it a little bit.
Like, 11, those new Yeezys?
Technically, the 11 points you mentioned, right?
You know the... The thing
no, but they fix shit. They make shit
better.
Yeah,
right? The fake manufacturers, they actually catch up with that shit.
Going crazy,
yeah, they buy fucking real shoes and then they try to replicate it as close as they can while keeping the costs super duper.
Those
low.
Dudes have the most fire collections. They got literally every pair, every even pairs pair. That you don't like. I don't, if whoever's listening to this, if they don't like a certain pair, it doesn't matter. That guy still has it.
Yeah, like 50 of them.
And he made a bunch of money off of
bro,
it.
Bro, they
actually.
Got the Red Octobers. They got all that shit. All the OG shit.
That's crazy,
all
bro.
The new school shit.
I'm going to look into that.
I need some Dior.
Some Dior's.
Oh,
yeah, but see, like, you know, how many people are wearing a $20,000 pair of shoes on the street?
Yeah, I would, even if I had the real pair.
I know, but the thing is, like, you know, I be the foam cup espresso Italiano
stealth
from home
welt,
type
bro.
Of guy. You know what I'm saying?
Stealth well.
I
love where it's at.
I feel it. I like it, but it's like there's only certain places, you know. Oh, yeah. Like, I know for a fact, like, I had a pair of those actually, the Dior's, but I sold them because that's the dump. Like, to take that money and invest it. You know what I'm saying? Like, what are you talking about? It's such just a stupid thing to, like, you know. I mean, yeah, sure, it'll gain value, but I can do faster returns now.
Yeah.
Instead of waiting 5 years, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you'd rather just time it later. Just be like, yeah, whatever.
And plus, what's the ceiling for it? I don't know. You
yeah,
know?
I feel that.
I don't know. So
and who knows? In 2 years, that shit might be worth nothing. Essentially.
Yeah.
Like,
so
I never
took those
do.
On. I never put those on ever. You know what I'm saying? Because I was
you
like,
bought
that
it for the flex, low key.
Like... No, I bought it because I was like, yeah, I'm gonna flip these right now.
Oh shit!
You know what I'm saying?
Oh no!
I paid retail and then flipped them. You know, so I was like, this is awesome. But like, if I saw a dude wearing them on the street, like at Chick-fil-A, I'd be like, no way, those are fake.
Yeah, yeah.
Just because, I mean, not to say that I'm underestimating someone. No, they're either fake or you're kind of making
super
bad decisions in your life.
I can see. Yeah, yeah.
I get it. Some people are like super rich.
Oh, yeah.
I get it. But that person's not somebody that rich is probably not. Waiting in line at Chick-fil-A.
I'm gonna be real, bro. No matter how rich you get, my guy.
Chick-fil-A is always gonna be there.
Three places I'll wait in line for. Chick-fil-A, Taco Bell, In-N-Out.
Why would you wait in line?
The trifecta.
Have somebody go get it for you.
But it's the fact of me going there, deciding what I want when I'm there.
Bro,
congratulations.
It's the experience.
Congratulations, you passed the test. You are the foam cup coffee at home guy.
No, I'm with him on that one, bro.
That's it's being like, humble, bro.
Yeah, for real.
But bro, don't. But you're not wearing Dior's, bro.
First day that they announced the Popeye's chicken sandwich. One of my friends told me that they did it a day earlier on a Friday. It was supposed to come out on Saturday.
Okay.
So I went in line at this Popeye's by our house, and there's a fucking Aventador in front of me. I'm like, how does this...
Yeah, but that yeah, that's because it's like he's like, yeah, dude.
No,
Instagram
he's hopping
photo.
On the Popeye flex. At
Instagram
that
photo. Yeah. That's funny.
Dude, he totally did that for the gram. Like, took the SV to Popeye's for the Sammy.
I feel like this guy has a pressing question right now.
No.
You don't? You look like you're...
No,
like,
I'm just...
You're like...
Here's what it is. Okay. Usually around this time, this is when I, for some reason, just start getting creative. So I go through these like images in my head where I'm just like, I'm flowing with the conversation, but with imagery.
I apologize for ruining that for you.
No.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Fucked up your flow.
No,
yeah,
you guys are good. Bad. I was having fun like that. I'm still listening. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel you.
But I'm absorbed by it.
No, I just thought like, because I feel like I noticed you like lunge for the question, you know?
No, I just felt it.
The type of lunge where it was like, hey, dude.
He had that lean. He's like,
well,
just waiting.
Yeah.
Like
waiting
a tiger in the brush.
Waiting to strike.
Can I be honest? Like,
no, you can't.
Honestly.
Were you lying before?
I was. But like, to be completely honest.
Oh, even better.
Okay.
Oof.
He was holding back. All right.
Only 75%.
I want to get your take on like the movie 2049, Blade Runner. Have you seen it?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Never heard
Perfect.
Of it.
Perfect.
Visuals, cool.
So nice.
The first one was better.
First one was better.
You thought the first one was better?
Yes.
Do you mean story-wise?
Just in terms of like the entertainment value.
But
okay, I could get behind
the
that.
Only
all
way,
of the, all
the,
of
the best way I can describe the whole movie was that it was, what the hell was the word? Jeez. Completely forgot the word.
But like,
you know,
no.
You know,
yeah, yeah.
If this is going to be very, like a very strange adjective for a genre of film, but I would say Blade Runner 2049 was like an ambient film.
Ambient?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where it's like,
okay, I remember the word 100%. The word was screensaver.
It was feels atmospheric.
Like a, it feels like an ultra HD fucking screensaver that you just want to have on all the time. And it's
yeah.
Just, I honestly forgot about the story. I was just like so
entranced. By I mean, just, you know, flexing the cinema 4D muscle. You know,
and then you look
up
what lights they used, and then you're like, oh my God, you can see where the budget's going. And
yeah. Not every movie, but yeah, most movies that are remakes.
For me personally, I talked to someone recently about Star Wars, and he's like, yo, the OG ones are like the best. And I was like, yeah, they're great storyline and all, but like, you know how fucking tight.
That's what I'm talking about. And yeah.
Like, the new concept of everything, like everything just looks better. That's what it is.
Entertainment value as a whole, like the, like includes the emotions that you have before you go in and when you leave. Like the whole experience of enjoying that movie, wherever it was, like at home. Like, did you plan a movie night or was it like, yeah, I'm just going to watch this at home on a Thursday?
Those
like,
movies,
if you're like, yo, everybody come through, I set up the projector in the backyard, we got snacks and shit, you're hyped for the movie. But if you're like, hey, I'm gonna just, you want to watch something on Netflix, like, oh, this looks good, click
bro,
it
some
it's
of the,
different
some of the best movies I've ever watched though, or the ones I have the best memories of, are the ones where I'm like, I'm just gonna see a movie. My buddy called me
because you judged the book by its cover. That's your fault. What? Give everything a chance.
What are you talking about, bro?
You should give all movies. You should be that hyped about all movies.
Dude. Nah, bro. No, hear me out. Hear me out.
Dennis,
did you see
the
new SpongeBob
bro?
Movie?
Hasn't there been two?
The latest SpongeBob movie.
When did it come out?
Oh, my God.
Like this year.
Well, no, I hate to be this year.
Yeah, like 2021.
What?
Like, late 2020.
Yeah, no, I did not see that one. Though.
Phenomenal animation.
What do you mean?
Phenomenal animation,
bro.
No, because
they made a 3D one.
Yeah, that's
like,
it.
No. They made two? Because I thought they made a 3D one like 2 years ago. Two or three-ish years ago.
This is a very different type of 3D.
Yeah, it's like a new like thing.
You're like,
have you seen Love, Death, and Robots?
Oh, dude, I'm watching
season my God.
Two right now.
I am so glad I discovered that last night.
You discovered it last night?
Last night.
How many have you watched?
Three.
I got halfway.
You watch them in order,
bro.
Go back and watch them in order.
All of them.
I mean, it's not like they're not tied together.
They're
it's,
not.
It's
but
an
you
anthology.
Just but they do a good job at structuring which episodes should go first and which one should go last.
That is true.
They tell like human stories, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like very like the story arcs are really good.
That's another thing where I was just
and
like, I was like, I'm gonna watch something.
Yeah. No, Love, Death, and Robots is the move. That's something we definitely do.
Okay.
We plant like it's an event. Yeah. You got to get the right crowd around you. You know what I'm saying? Like the homies that understand. You know.
Mm. Now, bro, I turned that shit.
What to look for and what to talk about. You know.
I was so amped when I saw. I was just scrolling through Netflix. I'm like, I can't watch YouTube right now. Like, I feel like I'm just going like super dumb. Love, Death, and Robots. New episodes. Oh shit.
You know, I waited for it. I got the ad.
You what?
An ad popped up.
Really?
For me.
That's how I am with Peaky Blinders. God.
Oh man.
This guy liked Peaky Blinders.
Literally
the best show on the planet.
The next season
of Peaky Blinders.
Oh, my God. It's so. Have you watched it?
No, I haven't. I've only watched like the first two episodes. It was good. I don't know why I never continued.
Continue for the love of God.
Like, I will be real. I watched the first two episodes. I'm like, I can't stand these accents. They were driving me crazy. And then after I got over that initial hit, like after 3 to 4 episodes in season one, this show is tight. Then like season two hit, I'm like, oh, it's heating up. Season three, this show is dope.
And then boom, like, Italians. Then you're like,
actually,
it.
Ironically
this guy
enough,
got transported.
What was season five? Was that the Russian like the czar?
Hey, stop! I'm gonna watch it. Stop.
Oh yeah.
It doesn't spoil anything.
I don't want to. I don't want to know anything about it.
Let it be a surprise.
I don't want to know anything about it.
Yeah, the politics.
Well, I'm not gonna mention. I'm not gonna mention him.
Hey,
That's true.
I've already seen it.
Just like no courtesy in this room, bro.
Dude, we're not spoiling anything for you.
Trying to do it for you, dude.
Bro, we ain't
I don't want to know that season 5 has politics. I don't want to know that.
Spoiling shit for you.
I don't want to know that there's
a
season 5.
You're the one who quit on the show, bro.
I don't want to know that there's a season 5.
Yeah, you said I'm done after 2.
Hey, well, I wanted to listen to your advice. Should I take
Cillian Murphy's
lightly?
In it?
Yeah.
I'll take your advice lightly. Okay, I know that. But I'm like, what?
No,
it's on Netflix? What? I want to experience the whole thing.
That's funny.
From researching how to watch Peaky Blinders. I want to start there.
That show's interesting because it says it's a BBC production.
Yeah.
But it's original. A Netflix series?
Yeah. Netflix distributed,
BBC owns the rights to it, but Netflix, I think, technically does all the production for it, if that makes any sense.
Do they?
I believe so.
I mean, the deal could be structured in countless
ways. Like Netflix manages production, I think, and then BBC just owns the rights to it.
That's dope.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Exactly.
Clout move.
Yeah, they use a lot of haze in that show, though. It's funny.
There's a lot of what?
A lot of haze, for sure.
Yeah.
For all the crap.
It's a lot of mist.
Like, just, I'm on
it's
a mist right
now. It's a very misty show.
Yeah, dude. There's a lot of
characters. I feel moist.
Just a
right
few,
after.
Like, you know, like three or four.
I like that.
But, like, super attached. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, my God.
Super attached to so many characters in the show, bro. Like, how people talk about Game of Thrones, I've never seen Game of Thrones my entire life because I just don't have the time for that.
Yeah.
But with Peaky Blinders, bro, like, there's people, like, I'm, like, fully invested. Like, if I see them in person, I will talk to them as if they were in character still from that movie or show.
Dude, Game of Thrones, like, I'm so glad you mentioned that.
Dude,
right
what
now.
Do you mean? If, no. if you're at Coffee Bean and you see freaking you're the Khaleesi, right now, you're like, House Targaryen? Like, what are you going to do? I don't understand.
You're telling me right now, if I seen Tom Hardy from his character
oh, dude,
in Peaky Blinders,
you're going to lose your mind. Like,
I'll ask him where the bread is at.
Tom Hardy? Tom Hardy?
Yeah, bro.
Tom Hardy's Bane, bro.
Yeah, okay.
You born in the darkness.
No, I think of Tom.
If you put Bane's voice in Peaky Blinders, the show would still be the same.
No, seriously, he's right. I swear to God.
You ruined it for me. Now I know. When I see his character, I'm like, okay, he's basically Bane.
No, it's... he steals the show, like, the scene every time he's on. Like,
well, he's Tom Hardy.
Yeah.
Did that show make him? No, right?
No,
where'd
no,
he come
no.
from?
He's been...
What was his, like, first thing?
Bronson was one of the earlier
yeah, that's
ones.
The wildest movie ever. Yeah. Have you seen Bronson too? He's like in prison or whatever.
I watched that with Zayd. He was like, "What the fuck was that, dude?"
It's like an American gangster like type of feel movie.
Gotcha.
No, Bronson is Charles Bronson is I think it's what is Britain's most notorious prisoner. He's done like the craziest shit like mm-hmm. a prisoner has done in Britain's history. He's unbelievably violent, like bipolar. As they come, like, and he'll just flip on a dime. It's like walks in to buy a ring. He's like, I'll have that one right there. She's like, or the guy's like, that's an expensive ring. Like, how much do you have to throw down? He's pissed off. Takes a dude's head, bangs him into the fucking counter. Chick comes over freaking out like, oh my God, don't fucking move. Like, he's crazy.
I like
it. It's a great movie. You should definitely watch it.
Sounds pretty aggressive.
It's a good character piece okay. if you're into movies like that. I don't know.
Definitely. Well, especially with an actor like Tom Hardy.
Bro, I was trying to tell you earlier, right, going in with no expectations to a movie.
Mm-hmm.
My friend invited me out. He was dating this girl, still is, and she brought one of her friends. They're like, we need a fourth person. You want to come? I'm like, for sure. Roll up to the theater. I don't know what we're watching. All I know is it's called The Lighthouse.
Okay.
I'm like, I know zero things. Yeah. I don't know any of the actors. I don't know. At this point, I didn't even know it was in black and white.
They didn't have a really big marketing run,
not
I feel like.
At
yeah.
all.
I heard about it through somebody else, and I was like, what?
I only saw ads for it after it had left theaters,
yeah.
like when it was on DVD. Mm-hmm. But I'm on. Yeah, right? Seriously. When it was on cassette.
Okay, sorry, Grandpa. Okay.
I came to someone's house and they have a DVD player. I'm fucking stone cold stunnering that. Where the hell?
How's my PS? I have a PS5.
Yeah, I was about to say.
It doesn't count. It doesn't say DVD.
Yeah, it does.
It does somewhere.
You're tripping,
on there, bro.
You know, anyway, what
they got Blu-rays.
What did you think of that movie?
It was unreal.
Yeah,
it was one of the best movies of the year.
It was the old cinema.
Yeah, it was old cinema.
It was like an homage to like old techniques.
It was just, I think it was the appreciation for those techniques mm-hmm. and like how they actually translated to modern, like a modern format.
Mm-hmm.
You know, modern projectors. It was unreal.
Mm-hmm. A24 Films, dude, is just. Way up there for me.
They've been killing it recently
with their like uniqueness and broad range of like stories, dude. It's just mind blowing. Honestly,
interesting. Yeah,
yeah. Have you seen that?
I have. Yeah,
Lighthouse. What do you think about it?
Yeah, I mean, that's my thought exactly.
The only thing.
Like it was just cool. It was like cool to like revisit that in a lot of ways, you know. And like, oh yeah, like it's kind of like remember where you kind of all came from type thing.
Mm-hmm. It's just like there's something about the way that black and white footage and especially the camera and film stock they were using, like the way it captures depth with shadows is unlike mm-hmm. modern film. Like
yeah,
the only thing that kind of comes close
and, yeah.
in a weird way, this is going to sound like such a bizarre comparison, is like Lego Movie. Just because mm-hmm. do you know about how their software works for their rendering engine?
No, which,
like their
which
f-stop
one is it?
Value. Oh my God, I'm totally blanking on
whose studio?
Called. I think it's I don't even think it's related to a studio.
Was it Sony? Was it Sony that put that movie out? I don't know.
Was it Sony? I don't remember
I don't
who put
who
it out, but I just
it.
Know that they had to Disney. Essentially hire the company that created the technology or the software. It has an f-stop value of like 30 or some crazy shit on it. So it renders light in a more realistic way to the eye. Like the way it runs through different materials, like yeah. it's
subsurface scattering.
Oh my God, it's crazy. Like that's yeah. why the Lego movie looks so crisp.
Yeah, yeah, like dude, it.
Because the like darkest it. Part is still visible.
So, can you Google weird. What that software is called?
Yeah, please. But, yeah. There's actually a there's a great YouTube video that breaks it down where it talks about the technology behind the Lego movie and stuff like that.
That's dope. I'm gonna check that out.
Yeah.
I've been messing around a lot in Cinema 4D.
Dude, I've been trying to learn Blender recently. Like just for job.
Blender's
purposes.
Cool too. I just gravitated towards Cinema 4D a long time ago.
It's what I'd
and
rather be
and
using.
played with it.
Yeah, of course.
Is it? I feel like Blender's catching up in a lot of ways. But I mean, but here's the thing, Cinema 4D's been doing it for so long that it's like
also
like
it's
structured
very
well. Also, in there, yeah.
Like Blender's good, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with Blender. But it's a free software. Mm. It's open source.
Right.
While Cinema 4D you have to pay for it and there's like, you know, yearly or
they decrease they I mean they recently decreased the barrier to entry. It used to be
really?
Yeah, you used to
how
have
much
to,
does it cost
you used to
now?
Have to buy it full for like I don't know.
I thought it was like $800.
It was
at
like $4,000.
Okay, never mind.
At one point, yeah, for like the full thing, I think it was like $3,995, something like that. Mm. At one point, if you wanted that, and then like Redshift was a different company.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying, which is the renderer.
Yeah,
and then they like recently merged all that. I mean, what's cool is Maxon, the company mm-hmm. that makes Cinema 4D, bought like the Red Giant like an editing suite. Are you familiar with that?
Yeah, Red Giant
for the Adobe stuff.
Yeah, I've got some assets from them.
Yeah, so they bought them and they bought Redshift. And I think on one other company,
okay.
and they bundle it into one thing. And it's like $89 a month.
That's actually really good.
So
knowing that.
Also, that's when I jumped on that like 3 months ago. I was like, that's it. Every night I've been like spending 3-4 hours a night just like making shit and just like learning.
Dude, guess what? Since our last conversation, I recently did something crazy and I quit my day job.
I like
that. No longer working at Target. It's free.
Dude, I used, abused, and... I'm now well happy because I got all my gear, got everything I needed. Now it's just time to
grind it out.
Grind out, dude.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell's up with the GPU shortage?
What's the action plan? I'll tell you about
now
that.
We're
what's the hell?
Quitting Target. What's up with the GPU shortage? What's going on, bro?
What's the action plan, though?
The action plan is I'm going to be doing 2 a.m. podcasts full time now.
I like
that. So I'm gonna be doing a podcast full time. I'm also gonna be doing like acting in New York over the summer.
Oh wow.
I'm doing a 2-week course for quite a lot of money.
This is news to me.
Dope.
Yeah, that's so I'm gonna be starting my like acting career. I'm gonna kind of venture out into the film industry, kind of see like the cool crap. At the same time, I'm gonna be still doing like cinematography work and things like that for other companies.
Yeah, you never know. It's for this industry, bro. It's like
you gotta be active in every little part, man.
Yeah, you have to, because you never know what you're in will be.
Yeah,
like into the big leagues.
That's very true. And a lot of it is exciting to me, whether it's editing, whether it's
you find somebody who like vibes with you and like thinks you're dope, and like an older cat, you know, gets you right in. You assist them for a while.
Need to start doing that.
Learn stuff, you know what I'm saying?
But
there's a lot to learn, bro.
I bought the time.
Yeah, that's dope.
I bought the time.
Good for you, bro.
Thank you.
Good for you. We talked about that last time. Right?
What have you been up to?
We did cool stuff, dude.
He's up to dope shit. That's what he's doing.
I know,
bro.
No, I'm hyped, dude. My happiness level is very high because of that. You know
fucking
what I'm saying?
Sick.
Yeah, dude. For real. I got to like shed a lot of the weight.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's awesome. That's
bogging
me
down and making me not love what I do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So as long as you love it. And the thing is, we can tell.
Well, how do you?
Like, you're just happy and dandy and glad to be here.
Just doing well.
I am glad to be here, bro. This is
hell
fun.
Yeah.
I hope so. That'd be weird if you weren't.
Sure.
So it's like, God, I hate being here.
No, like, God damn it.
Logan, you're setting
we're going. We're going.
You're setting a weird ass.
No, nothing like that. Logic. Animal logic?
Mm. And they used supposedly the Lego digital designer.
I think, yeah.
Maya
XSI is probably what it is, because Maya is open. Anybody can buy that, but XSI. Interesting. I'm going to look into that.
It's some crazy software, man.
Yeah, dude. I've been working with some...
really
some
cool people.
Wild people, bro.
Yeah, I see you reposting, and I'm like, damn, dude, you're doing great. Like, it's fucking awesome.
Alhamdulillah, bro.
Alhamdulillah. Feels, always, man.
Feels good.
Alhamdulillah.
So
yeah,
for real.
Logan made our guest a Habibi chair today.
He deserves it.
You got that for the vlog?
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah, dude.
Cool. Yeah, for real. But yeah, man, exciting things. It's I feel like it's been like an opportunity, like a new opportunity opened.
Mm-hmm.
and like the right people fell into place at the right time.
And you're just you're kind of just standing back there watching it happen, kind of like you're like,
yes,
yeah, everything's.
You want to know what's crazy? Is there was like you're gonna freak out. Are you ready? I had an exchange with somebody, with like an important individual in this story. Mm-hmm. I had a like conversation with him, and he responded to me on February 22nd. I looked back at it recently, and I was like, "There's literally no way." I can find it.
For
find
all
it
of those wondering
this.
What okay. we're talking about before yeah. this pod, can you let them know what the deal is with 222?
I don't know what the deal is. That's
no,
the
let,
thing.
No, don't, I don't let, know. Let them know.
Anytime I found myself doing something that had some sort of benefit or positive impact on an important component of my life, anytime I've been in a place or around that thing, within a very short period of time, usually like 24 hours, I see the number 222 somewhere. And then when I probably shouldn't share that, but yeah.
Why not?
That's the story.
Why not?
No, because it's got like secret information. It's got
some top secret information right there.
Yeah. But yeah.
Ooh. Got the hippie jeebies.
We're getting into numerology.
Cool, and then like I just got here today and the door across from yours, the number is 222. Please, after you post this episode, post that on your story so people know I'm not joking.
This is going on TikTok, guys. Hey, do a little dance, dude.
This guy was supposed to do, I'm
just mind blown.
I can't get myself to do a TikTok dance, bro. I tried. I think I just like don't have moves, you know?
All right, can we do this? Can we all just do this? In 3, 2, 1. There we go.
Don't edit anything.
No.
Nah, for real, dude. That was wild. I was like, whoa. They're like, what? Be there. Yeah.
Or like, yeah, can
you
put this in?
Yep.
Don't do it.
I know. I like that. Yeah. Yeah, they forget to cut that part out.
Or they do it on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Well, that happens with like 2-hour episodes.
With our episodes?
Yeah. Well, no, like general podcast episodes.
I said our episodes.
Only your episodes.
Okay. Ours.
Ours, yes. Our episodes.
Sorry, Zayd.
Yeah.
Why did I now just get that?
That's
Zayd, if you're hearing this, I love you and... just don't listen.
If you're hearing this,
it's too late.
A lot of shade being thrown.
Welcome back to the 2 a.m. podcast. Had to take a little intermission there. Mm-hmm. Nice little pee break.
Yeah, hope you enjoyed
it. You had a pee?
I was thinking about it, but mm-hmm. I was like, no, I can save it for later. Mm-hmm. I can save it for when I get home.
Like that. Let it,
he wants
let
to do
it
with
fester.
Me, that's why.
Yeah.
Let it fester.
I like to manifest things.
Mm-hmm. Manifest?
I'm pretty sure it's already manifested, my guy.
I'm going to manifest this piss later.
I like this naked. The beverage... the selections here are great. I gotta get you some sultan though.
We gotta teach you some stew lingo.
I gotta get you some sultan.
Wanna learn some stew lingo up in here or what?
Sure, go ahead.
All right. So first of all, it's called stew.
Understood.
For obvious reasons.
Yeah, I think that's a self-explanatory. Yeah,
exactly. What's the second thing?
You don't have like a stew dictionary?
We don't.
Brand book?
We should make one though.
Yeah, make a brand book.
Stew dict, D-I-C-T, like SpanishDict.com. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Stew dict?
Yeah.
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 That could be a lot of things, though, you know?
So, a lot of...
oh, no, I want it to be.
Yeah.
I want people to think that for sure.
I don't know if you noticed, but...
is this porn or the 2 a.m.?
When you drive here, you can already get a hint of what the area is like.
Huh?
So, every once in a while, as we're leaving the stew, we kind of, you know, meet people we don't really want to see or people that are just acting very weird.
Okay.
Right. Like, we saw Tarzan once. Remember?
Tarzan?
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Sometimes people will stop and talk to you. We call it PWs. P-dubs.
P-dubs, okay.
Philosophical worms. Where you're engaged in a conversation that is not going anywhere, and it's in every direction possible. And you're just
like that.
You're like, how?
So you had to invent your own name for crackhead, or?
Yeah, pretty much.
Got it. Okay.
We try to come up with names here.
Bro, we've had a lot of weird like run-ins with homeless people around here. Like,
oh, okay.
I mean,
like
they're
that, okay.
They're kind of like, you know,
are there, okay.
they're in the area.
That sucks, bro.
No, it's whatever, you know? They're usually not bad. Like,
no, that sucks for them.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, definitely. 100%
yeah,
sucks
you know
for
what I'm
them.
Saying?
Like,
not for you.
It's really weird.
You're good. Just get in your car.
It's,
oh, yeah.
Bro, it's really trippy now. It's like sometimes you can come outside and it's like, oh, that's meth. Like, you know the scent now. Like, certain people. I'm not even joking. Yeah, like,
interesting.
It's crazy.
Like, I've seen some people, like, do some interesting shit around here. Like, some dude pushed a shopping cart past our building with two ladies. I don't know if he was a pimp or if it was just, like, two friends of his. But they went around to like this building that was farther down and you could just see these like thick plumes of like whitish yellowish smoke, and I'm like, oh, that's probably like meth or some other shit that they're smoking down there. Like
he went and bought them or what?
Huh? I don't fucking know, bro.
What was that?
I don't know if they're barebacking out in the open, but that seems a little risky. Like, yeah. For a business complex.
No, dude. The worst thing I saw was that lady that started taking off her clothes in front of the building.
Oh, no, really? Dude.
Yeah, and the sandwich hut was closed.
What's your landlord say about that?
I mean, he never really shows up, yeah. So it's like...
What if you call him and say, hey...
Well, we have, like, we have a security dude who, yeah. Like, watches the building, and he'll yell at all those people, tell them to get the fuck out, like... He's
okay, so
yeah, he's usually on it.
Okay.
I mean, there's been plenty of times where it's like you come out to your car and there's just homeless people sleeping outside of the building. You're like, oh.
Cool.
And now you have that moral dilemma. You're like, do I wake them up and tell them like, hey, this is private property, like you should go, or should you stick with like, they're not really bothering anybody. You know, they're just trying to take a little siesta.
Definitely with they're not really bothering anybody, because I feel like there should be more solutions. You know, to that.
Well, definitely,
100%.
But I don't think we should get into that political conversation because it's a long one. But like, either way, I just feel like, you know, just let the landlord do it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, literally. The security guard comes and that's his job. He can deal with it.
And I mean, like, what's ironic is there's in my neighborhood, cars get broken into more frequently than they do here.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, you don't need to worry about that shit down here, at least as of right now. Not I haven't really. Heard of it happening. I know Zayd left his windows open for an entire fucking day, and his trunk pops open mysteriously sometimes, just like abacadabra, bitch, pops open randomly.
Bro, yeah, that's
I swear to God, like, we've walked outside plenty of times, and his trunk is just wide open.
And then the funniest thing is he'll tell you, my bad. It's like, bro, it's your car.
Wait, are you sure it wasn't just because like somebody was in there?
No, no one was in there.
Because that little pull tab. Somebody could have like, and then like,
no, bro,
slid out so you can't see them from where you're sitting.
You're right. I've seen those.
How many people have you had in your
trunk? This has happened.
Trunk?
At least when I've seen it, it's been 3 times.
So clearly the latch is not working.
No, the latch is totally screwed. And I'm like, dude, you should get that fixed. And he's like, yeah, I'll get it done.
Clearly, Well.
He's in Puerto Rico. He's in Costa Rica. He's in Costa Rica.
Yeah, bro.
That's the kidnap capital of the world.
You guys need a museum.
That's a kidnap capital of the world.
Get your ass in this.
I just made
this man.
I just made that statistic up. I apologize, but but I'm pretty sure.
It says like some crazy fact, and someone asked, "What's the source?" And then it just says me.
Yeah, I like that. I like that. That's funny. That's funny. My wife says I do that all the time.
That's hilarious.
She's like, no, like, who told you that? And I'm like, I'm pretty much positive this is the case. And she's like, but who told you that? And I can't remember. But I genuinely can't remember. You know? Like, that's RAM information. My brain is hard drive.
So
it'll go to the RAM and I'll store it. When that person tells me for 2 weeks, I'll remember that person told me this.
Yeah.
But then after that, it's just the important part of that memory is stored on the SSDs. You know what I'm saying?
We're on the SSD.
And the RAM purges every time I restart. That's it.
Bro, I know the feeling.
You're unreal, man.
Like, I got into
I swear, bro.
I got into a fucking, the weirdest argument with my dad, right? We're watching a commercial.
A lot of stories start.
And then all of a sudden, like it was a commercial for just lawnmowers, like John Deere shit, right? Mm-hmm. That you buy at Home Depot, whatever. Mm-hmm. And so I told my dad, oh, I don't know if you know this, but like for the past 4 or 5 years, there's been a huge ongoing legal battle with John Deere over the right to repair their shit. Because apparently for like the past 4 or 5 years, when you buy a John Deere tractor and you're like, you know, a farmer, you don't own the tractor. You're just renting it essentially for a one-time fee, right? And then if you have any repairs, you have to take it back to them. And so essentially anything that breaks on it, you're like, oh, I could just replace the part, no problem, right? Wrong, because everything's runs through their ECU now. So you have to go take it back. They have to reflash the ECU, which only they can do. It's a fucking nightmare.
Wow.
And so my dad started arguing with me, bullshit. He's like, I know for a fact that they're allowed to modify their shit because that's what farmers have been doing for fucking ever. And I'm like, I'm telling you right now, there's this John Deere shit that's going down. It's real. Like,
that's crazy.
I can prompt. And he's like, how can you prove this? I'm like, I just know these things. That's the RAM memory.
Yeah.
That's my point.
Like, I read it one time and then I looked it up probably another time and I read it on some website and then I checked my sources. Like, I did it at one point.
Dude,
I don't remember when or where.
After 20 minutes of arguing with him about fucking John Deere, I finally pull up the YouTube video where it's all about the legal battle and shit. And he's like, I don't believe you. Just leaves it.
Well, like, that's a dad move. Nah. That's definitely a dad move. But like, why didn't you pull up the evidence in the first 35 seconds? See, that's being inefficient.
No, sometimes it's like you need to pass the time.
Oh, you're just having a good time?
Yeah, we were like, yeah. It was more like we were fucking with each other, but around like the 375% in, it got really heated. And I'm like, oh, this is where
which
we need
always
to
happens.
The,
yeah,
we
yeah.
need to pull up the information.
Okay,
now.
So yeah, you treated it as an entertainment stunt.
Oh yeah, 100%.
More than just like an information stunt. Gotcha.
Or it's like every day you test the waters. You
that's
know?
That's
like,
called being human.
Yeah, he's a car guy, right?
Doing that is called being human, like having the compassion and like the willingness to like make it a longer conversation when you know you could end it right now.
Like he's a car guy. And there's like, for some reason, I'm kind of into older Japanese shit. Mm-hmm. Like, not as my favorite, right? That's clearly not my favorite, but it's something I'm starting to grow a fondness for. Mm-hmm. And he was alive during the era when those cars were coming out. So he remembers them as fucking shit boxes. He's like, they're terrible to drive, like the worst clutches, the brakes always fail, all that shit. And so I'll just like randomly ask him shit. And I'm like, did you see that link that you sent that I sent you the other day? And he's like, no, what was it? I'm like, you know, the 240Z. And he's like, dude, why would you even send me that? And then he just goes on this whole rant of like
how he
hates the 240Z. And he's like, dude, you should definitely be getting some kind of, I don't fucking know, like some little British piece of shit.
That's funny, bro.
You know, you just test the...
You just like to play a game.
No,
yeah.
you like to dip your toe in
it. It depends on what
while.
Kind of dad you have, too. You know,
that's
you,
true.
For sure.
I mean, it's not like he's hucking a shoe at me.
Dude, no, I'm saying like what type of dad you have to be willing to just send him shit to like screw with him. You know what I'm saying?
My dad sends me shit.
Yeah, I'm sure.
And I'm like, he's like, did you watch it? I'm like, yeah, totally. And then like, never watch it. Usually it's about some stuff I don't support.
It's like some really serious ass politics.
That, that's
and
being
like,
a liar.
Holy shit.
But yeah, sure. That's being a liar, but yeah.
Like too serious shit, bro.
I feel you. It's not the vibe.
You're like, dude, this shit is heavy. I do not need this in my day.
Like life lessons. Mm-hmm. Why do you have Gary V on my Instagram? I don't need more.
Gary V. Wow, I flipped this door for $40.
Fucking dude.
Okay.
Like, listen, dude. I understand.
Sounded more like a very geek.
I understand. I understand flipping shit. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But there comes
I mean,
a limit. There was
yours,
a craze
like...
recently. I'm sure you've heard of it. Baseball cards.
Oh,
NBA.
You mean Pokemon. Let's be real.
Pokemon.
We're talking Pokemon cards.
He said,
well, not even Pokemon.
He said craze
dude.
Recently.
I mean, obviously, it's been happening.
Like, it caught little kid hype, like TikTok hype. Yeah,
yeah, it caught it's, TikTok hype.
Yeah, yeah.
That would be a perfect way
didn't
to
like one
it.
Of the Paul
but
Brothers
here's the thing.
Tattoo,
it's TikTok hype. But here's the problem. When you go visit retail stores, everyone is 30 plus.
Mm-hmm.
And they're all dressed up in their, like, Mets outfit. And they're like, yeah, man, we're collectors. I'm like, you're resellers, you fucking...
Like, you don't collect,
don't make
bro.
Me say it, huh? Mm-hmm. You don't collect, yeah. But it's just like, what the hell's going on? Because fights were breaking out. People were losing their jobs because of it.
I mean, I'll stab like, someone for a Charizard. A holo.
Bro, I don't play games.
Holo,
so
I got
don't...
some Japanese ones that
damn.
Only released in Japan. I got 10 of them.
Shit.
So you were in this
I
game.
I will take that.
You're invested in this market.
But I've been you're in this it. Game, bro. I had some Pokemon cards, which unfortunately got thrown away because I got bad grades when I was in fourth grade. But I recently found a picture of myself. I'll send it to you. You can put it on the screen if you want.
Please.
Where I'm holding a binder open. Over here, I have, like, every version of Blue Eyes White Dragon from Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah.
And over here, I had, like, hella Pokemon cards, bro. Like,
oh, my God.
All kinds of shit. I was like, cool, that's my next three children's college fund in that picture
yeah.
that you threw away you because threw I got away. D's or whatever.
Learning
about freaking history.
There goes college.
A moment of silence for the cards.
My blue eyes! No, dude, no, it's like... Real. Now, I remember I was into Yu-Gi-Oh cards and Pokemon cards like way, way back in the day.
I never played Pokemon.
I never played it. I liked the art. Like, that's why I asked.
Yeah, I
for
was
them.
Like trying to have the binder. You
yeah,
know
I just, I loved looking at them. I didn't give a shit what they were for. Like, I didn't play the games. I didn't care about the figurines. I was just like, I don't know. They were like, it's a little picture, you know? Like, every single one was made by a person and it's all very personal.
Mm-hmm.
I liked it, you know? Yeah. They all have their own little backstories on the cards and shit. And so I collected them. They're somewhere in a storage unit that we have. I don't know where. And I'm wondering if there's just like $1 million sitting in there. I don't know, man. I mean, like,
depends on when you started collecting.
This would have been like,
I think it was like 2000. And
I probably started when I was six and like really
three?
Ended when I was like 8 or 9.
Okay, so a solid 2.5 years.
Sounds about right. I still remember how the binders used to look too.
Yeah,
like
hell
zip
yeah.
up binders.
I still have
oh,
one.
Dude, yeah. they were the, oh my God. Like, those
so,
were such a flex.
I actually got one recently.
CDs.
Yeah, how's the Yu-Gi-Oh market?
Just have their car, 50 different CDs.
Dude, I remember, or like DVDs on a long car trip. If you got like one of those little pop down screens in your car in the back seat, it was live back there in the Escalade,
in the Lade, bro, on the back of the seat.
Had one in like a
Oh, yeah.
Two TVs on the back of the headrest.
Dude.
Play Halo in the whip.
Flex.
I did that before. Yeah, I did that. I used to play my Xbox 360, and I had to get like an adapter to plug it into like the.
Oh my god,
dude! That, dude, I remember.
Yeah, we were going to like Arizona or something with my family.
Yeah.
And we had a little TV, and it had the RCA.
Do you remember the Pandora's battery?
Yeah. Do you remember Dazzles?
What I think what I might like explain.
You're not a gamer.
No. Explain
Dazzles.
It.
Hold the hell.
No, Dazzle. You're not a gamer.
Remind me.
It's the first generation capture cards, like RCA, into the back of the Xbox 360, like the red, white, yellow, white cable, the RCA cables.
Yeah,
would plug into
yeah.
that, and then that would plug in RCA cables out into the Xbox, and then it would like store it, and then you have to plug it into your computer. Elgato. Yeah.
Literally. Whoa.
It was a capture card before like what they are now.
Oh, it was a capture card. Yeah, that's. I wouldn't have been into that.
Yeah, you're ahead of me for sure.
I was way too.
I was recording Call of Duty clips, bro.
Oh my god, dude, you're about it. Since
Modern Warfare 2. I'll show you a clip. I'll show you a clip after
that is so yeah. sick.
I have old ones where I made like stupid videos for my friend Omar. It was funny. It was like, and this is like videos for Omar.
Yeah,
like I wrote that shit on the video. You know what I'm saying?
On the
yeah.
Honestly,
you know? Yeah,
you should.
I should.
You definitely
I should. I'm gonna
send
him to FaZe. Actually, sign me.
That's down, dude.
360s with freaking
bro,
intervention.
FaZe Tariq.
No, but
FaZe T.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, dude.
Thanks for coming out, dude.
For sure, man. It's
honestly
always a good time.
It's always a good time. It's always a vibe. It's fun being around you.
I appreciate
damn.
That, dude.
Wait, damn, are we cutting it quits right now, bro?
Not what quits. I mean,
he's leaving.
No, he said he had a meeting,
then, dude. We're having a good time.
I pushed it. Whatever you want to do.
Really?
Yeah, we could talk a little longer if you
fuck
want.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I'm here.
Well, we're not saying goodbyes. I just wanted to shake his hand, to be honest. But
well, no, I said bye, so now I
he
have
just
to
wanted to hold your hand.
Now I feel weird. Now I feel like I don't belong here.
He's the one that he's trying to kick you out, bro. I want you to
clearly.
Say
yeah.
No, I clearly misunderstood it.
No, I had him. Yeah, I had it. A
yeah.
thing, but it's
okay. Okay.
No, I need to understand.
Gotcha. I just need to know a time slot, huh?
Because vibes over,
yeah. fuck yeah.
I was gonna say vibes over bags, but not really. But
well,
you know,
no, not really, but kind of. You know what
it's
I'm
like
saying?
Like today's Sunday, you know.
What was that? What was that spaceship video you showed me?
Spaceship video.
It was that guy that modeled his studio or whatever the hell it was after. It was a deck. It was a full deck, like
So you're involved
space deck.
In the YouTube space, obviously, but how, like
now more newly.
Yes,
newly, yeah.
yes. But like, how long have you been on YouTube? Like, do you know certain creators in like different areas? Like, for example,
my first videos that had like 10,000 views were in 2000 and I don't know, like 11, 12 years ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you've been on the space quite a bit longer
than I made Snapchat filters before Snapchat filters, bro.
Damn.
On YouTube.
Damn.
Not even a flex.
Oh,
it just
geez.
Pisses me off.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I did this before Snapchat was even a thing.
You were way too ahead of the game.
I made
bro.
Like a little demon face. I think I was watching like Andrew Kramer videos. I don't know. Do you know Andrew Kramer video co-pilot?
Hey guys, Andrew Kramer here.
Andrew Kramer here. And today
yes.
we're going to, and then, yeah, you remember that?
Yeah, hell yeah.
I love Andrew Kramer.
You know how
bro?
Much I learned from him?
Video co-pilot?
Yeah, dude.
Shout out Video Co-pilot.
Honestly,
shout.
Huge
they're
shout
doing,
out.
They're doing like, I'm pretty sure they're doing like major shit. I think there was like a, the 2020 like Adobe Summit.
Yeah.
And he was like a speaker.
Whoa.
Really?
For Adobe. Yeah. Like talking about the new tech and After Effects
yeah.
and stuff.
He deserves
I'm pretty
it.
Sure.
I think
oh, yeah,
I
bro. Are you kidding me?
I think it was
Andrew
his
Kramer?
Voice in the new Adobe 2021 tutorials.
That's so lit, bro. That's
I think
exactly
so.
What it should be.
Yeah.
Bro, I still
he
use Element
it.
3D
yeah.
on After Effects.
Bro.
Element 3D is
bro,
the move.
After Effects is actually glorious if you
it
know
is.
How to render out.
Yes.
I would say that.
That
yeah.
That almost feels like one of the hardest parts for me, Loki. Like
rendering.
Well, rendering. Well, usually on a you know real production, you'll probably have somebody cutting and
mm-hmm.
modeling and doing all that, and
yeah.
somebody else rendering.
Mm-hmm.
There's two different trades.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Two
yeah.
different professions.
Definitely.
Yeah, but that's why I'm trying to learn Cinema 4D and Redshift and like just make.
Just so you
my,
can be
just
that
go
one guy.
From start to finish, like just be the guy who did it. You know what I'm saying?
That
and
is,
also like
because
yeah.
then you can control it.
That's sick.
And if you're leading productions too, it's like you could better chime in if you hire somebody to do that.
That mm-hmm. is 100% correct.
Yeah,
like I don't know if you saw this. Let me see if I can.
Probably not. I'm just gonna go out on
this.
Whoa. So for all the people out there, I'm looking at. I'm assuming you made this.
Yeah.
This is an Element.
No, this is a Cinema 4D.
Cinema 4D, but you used some trash elements, I'm imagining.
Yes.
It looks good, man. It looks really
but that
good.
Was like a quick, and just like camera movement, rotation, trying to understand lighting, HDRIs. Like, I'm just learning all of it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
it looks good, too.
Thank you.
I
actually,
like the
scroll down.
I really like the reflection off of the water from the sun right there.
Yeah.
That looks nice.
Scroll down, or the other way?
Oh,
Yeah, right there. That's another one.
Oh, you made one of the satisfying loops?
Kind of, but like a little more demented.
I like that. What is that? Like a color shift at the end right there?
RGB separation.
Ah, that's what it is.
I separated the three channels and then like brought them back together.
Sick.
Yeah, you separate them by like what I imagine is a couple centimeters or something. Like
pixels, yeah. I don't remember what this.
That's dope.
I'm just riffing, bro. You know?
No, that's really cool.
It's fun, man.
Definitely.
The reason I say that is because you mentioned that you, or like showed you that, is because you said you want to use Cinema 4D, and I think you definitely should.
I should.
It's just a great tool to know.
It really
is. A great tool to have in your arsenal.
I mean, that's what made the intro for the Clips channel. I don't know if you saw that piece of garbage I made, but
you made it in Cinema 4D?
No, I made it with Blender. Yeah, nice. I didn't have Cinema 4D.
I have not seen it, but I will definitely look at it.
It was my, if you ever go to the Clips at the 2 a.m. Clips on YouTube, that intro, I made that on Blender, and I made it. It took me like 2 or 3 days to figure out just how to make it. Mm-hmm. And then rendering it was a complete nightmare.
Yeah.
I remember your call.
It took me twice as long just to figure out how to render the thing. Like,
rendering's tough, dude.
It was not wanting to work.
This guy calls me and he's like, dude, I can't for the life of me figure out what the hell is going on.
Well, what was annoying was,
do you remember the color situation?
Dude, okay. So like,
okay, can I pull
it up? And I was like, okay, slow down.
Yeah, pull it up, pull it up.
Let me just pull it up so I can have a reference.
Sure.
You need a young Jamie in here.
Yes, we do.
That's normally me. I normally have my laptop out, but I don't know why I didn't do that today.
2 a.m. Young clips. Jamie.
2 a.m. clips. Yeah, we should not be having you pulling it.
Was I not subscribed?
See how everything's off without Zaid, dude?
Whatever. It is what it is.
I don't, it's not coming up though. I don't know if
on
I'm
YouTube?
Being an idiot. Yeah. Instead for 2 a.m. clips. Oh, there you go. The 2 a.m. clips,
yes,
actually.
Sir. The 2 a.m. clips. We're not big enough just to be 2 a.m. clips yet. A little dinky into the...
Gotcha, that's dope.
Thank you. But all those signs, I like... The thing that was driving me crazy was those, like, you know, those arches. I was trying to make those out of glass. Like, and I set the texture to be glass, like,
but then you're trying to light them.
Yeah, I was trying to make it so that there was a light element in the center of them. So
here's
it's
a little
like,
3D tip. Shrink it more than you normally would. So let's say if you had like the cylinder, the tube, and you have the glass as an outer material, give that glass thickness first of all, so the refractions are realistic. It's not just the tube, right? When you have a glass pipe, it's there are two layers. There's an inside radius and an outside radius.
That's true.
That, and when you put that, the glass materials respond better to it. That's the first thing. The second thing is when you shrink the light source that's inside that, it should be two separate elements if it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
It is.
Yeah. Shrink that inside that. Shrink it about 20 to 30% more than you think you should. And then you can enhance it in post with glow. So that will glow and fill that space back in. Oh. So it looks like it's glowing.
The problem I was having was that the outside tube would not turn into glass, and it was because of the I think it was the rendering system I was in. There's like, what is it, EV and is it cycles?
I'm not really familiar. Okay. So I've heard of cycles, but I haven't heard of EVE.
There's like cycles and EVE, which is EEVEE, if I remember correctly.
EVE, okay, yeah,
something like that. And I believe one of them's used for like, if you're working on like a video game model, you know, you would do that, and then the other one works a lot better for cinematography or stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And for the one that works better for cinematography, it was like something with the Blender render, like every time you went to export it, that clear glass would turn into just like a really bizarre kind of gray, but still transparent.
What kind
of
lighting did you have in the scene?
I believe...
Because glass, like to understand glass and to see glass as being see-through, there has to be light. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, there was no, there was light in the center of it, though.
Yeah.
So, like, you could still have that light.
No, but
be
light
able to...
outside of it to refract from the outside. Because the light in the center is generating all the refractions on the inside. If you were inside that tube, it would probably look a lot more like glass.
But what
than
if it
on
was
outside.
Nighttime and there's hypothetically no.
There's light. There is always light.
That is true. Because it could have been light. The moon, but at the same time, it was in space. So that, right. That really would have been.
But if you wanted to achieve the look of transparency, there has to be something behind it to make it transparent. And that's a combination of light and texture. Light
that's
and,
true.
And, you know, did you have stars in that?
I did, but
they
way
didn't
I,
show through there.
I think what the problem was is like every time I just went to render it, it turned into like a solid object, but it still had transparency, so the glow could get through.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. It was refracting light from the inside, not from the outside. In order for it to look like glass, there have to be streaks or like, I mean, look at that.
Hmm. Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see
like
what you're
every
saying.
Type, different type of glass or different shape of glass has its own like refraction index, right? Like, look at the TV. You know what I'm saying?
But what I'm saying is you couldn't even see through the glass is the thing.
To the light source?
How do I frame?
I like how this conversation just got hella technical.
Yeah. No, it's very technical.
I'm picturing is knobs, dude.
No, the thing is, it's like, I don't have the expertise to like really dive into this because, you know, I'm still learning how to use Blender. And
same
like,
here. I'm just trying to like,
the only
know,
reason
I'm
I even got into
it.
Blender was so I could better understand 3D shapes and apply that to CAD because I'm going to be working with that like probably a lot in the future.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was in there, the thing was, it just looked like shit. Like, I don't know, because I don't think it would be a matter of outside light bouncing off of it, because there would be no outside light to do that. Because
no, but the light from the one next to it should be shining light on it. Do you see what I'm saying? The green light from the one next to it should be refracting on the outside.
Yeah.
But it can't refract on the outside because usually most softwares like that, they interpret dynamics or like lighting like that. Mm-hmm. So like once it hit the glass on the inside, it thinks its job is done. It's not going to continue refracting.
Oh.
Do you see what I'm saying? So the green light from the pipe here should be refracting onto the pipe here.
Yeah.
And the one here should be refracting onto the one here on this face, right? So you should technically see like the glow or the reflection of the other pipe.
Okay. No, I see what you're talking about. Here's my issue, right? Like, say hypothetically that arch was in front of you and you were looking at the arch like this, you wouldn't even be able to see through it.
Yeah.
Like, it became opaque.
Yes.
Right? Okay. I don't think it had anything to do with surface reflection.
Refraction index is probably like a slider. Or
I don't know
refraction scale. I don't know what they would call it, but there should be like something that has to do with refraction.
All I remember is every tutorial I watch
on how to make
neon in Blender, I applied it to that tutorial, and every time I rendered it,
it
came out looking like a solid line. Like, I read that intro.
I swear there was probably like a little check.
It's probably something so dumb.
So like one checkbox that like changes everything.
That's,
and when you find that,
I swear to God.
Last night this was happening to me. I could not figure out how to create something. And I like at the 3:45 in the morning, I found the box. I checked it. I saw that it worked. I clicked save, closed it, and went to sleep. I was like, I'm done.
Oh my God.
I spent three hours. Why is it like that?
It's always when you're like so under pressure that you're just like,
no, that's not a waste.
What's going on?
No, it's not a waste.
No, because now you know for the future.
And now
like,
I found all the other shit along the way. Like, oh, damn, I didn't know you could do that.
Exactly.
Oh, damn, I didn't know you could do that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Note to self.
Yeah. Dude, you watch on YouTube? Benny. I like Benny, dude. Benny Productions. Yeah, yeah. Okay, let me tell you about this kid, dude. Benny, shout out Benny Productions. I've been doing this forever, right? Like, photoshopping and all that stuff. He does Photoshop exclusively, right? But I saw him approach a task halfway through one of his videos differently, and it literally quadrupled my efficiency in Photoshop.
Really?
From one thing.
What did he do?
Like, the way that he approached how he used layer masks and adjustment layers was different than how I used to do it.
What's this guy's name?
Benny Productions.
Benny.
He's like some young kid. I don't know where he's from. He's like in Europe somewhere, I think. But like,
I'm gonna watch
him. Dude, he's dope. Same. He's incredible, bro. He has everything figured out. Somebody in my Photoshop stream actually was like, hey, do you watch Benny Productions? I don't remember who it was, but shout out to anybody from the stream who's watching this. But
shout out to the stream in general.
twitch.tv/Tarek_EM.
Hell yeah. Yes.
So anyway, this kid told me, hey, do you watch Benny Productions? I was like, no, why? And he's like, I feel like you guys should work on something together or something like that. I was like, okay, cool. I'll check him out. And then like eventually his name popped up on YouTube and I was like, oh shit, that's the guy that he told me about.
Yeah.
And then I clicked it and I was like, damn, this kid is going to town, bro. He's good. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
But it was like, he has a different art style. He does more like kind of stylistic, kind of animated works. I mean, he can do some photorealistic stuff too. He's good. But like, you know, just the way that he approached like using an exposure adjustment layer to paint it on in a way that I wasn't doing it. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get
like
what I'm
to paint on and deal with. I would like, I'll give you a quick example. Like I would usually, which may be inefficient, but it's the way that I learned. I would add like a levels adjustment layer, adjust all the levels in the image, and then go back and paint.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Use a layer mask, paint white in, and then now I have the effect that I need. Instead, he clicked. Vibrance, for example, decrease the vibrance, or exposure, decrease the exposure, adds a layer mask there, inverts it, and then starts painting. And I'm like, why did I never fucking think of that?
Yeah, bro. Whoa.
Right? Inverts it and then paints it in where he wants it.
Bro, what the hell?
Right?
Why?
Bro, you can apply that to everything in Photoshop.
That's insane.
It's working. Like, I used to work like this, I feel like.
Yeah, literally. You know how, like literally, as you go through phases, there's a part where you're working with layers only.
Yeah.
There's another part where you're just selecting a bunch of tools. and then there's like they're segmented, right?
Yes, but so like that's so efficient. Always, How did I never think of that?
The fact that you're going and then.
And then go back there instead of starting here and coming back. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? Start here, go there.
That like literally, I've unlocked two things tonight. That's yes. crazy. Well,
what's the first one?
The first one was earlier when we did the.
So you didn't unlock it. It was in RAM memory.
RAM memory.
You forgot it. No, I'm just kidding.
I'll remember it.
Yeah,
oh, because we have it on video.
All right, yeah. No, for real. That's that. So when I saw that, I was like, dude, this is dope. But dude, you have to. I'm telling you, man, the younger generation, bro.
Gotta look out for those.
They're coming from a different place. Not look out for them. Nurture them. Yeah. I want to be like where Kai is right now for me is where I want to be for the next kid.
Yeah.
At some point, 10 years from now. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
20 years from now, whatever. Yeah.
You know? I feel that. I've been doing a lot with my little brothers recently. That's cool. Like I'm trying to get them like, I'm like, all right, let's take a look at your room. I'm going to build you whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, dude, that's a perfect
opening
line.
Rooms lately too, bro.
Dude, yeah, I'm like, that's exactly what you need, you know? Let's get you an environment.
Nice.
I think if you train them on that, things will happen.
I'm about to start on mine too at my house. I've been doing it for other people recently, but
dope.
Now I'm doing it for myself.
Calm down. Yeah, we still got you in mind whenever we move the hell out of here.
We better crank that budget up, my friend. I'm in that's demand now.
That's the goal, bro.
No, I'm just playing.
Like, well,
I'm
we want the best.
200
No, it is. Yeah, there's some exciting things coming. I wish I could talk about them.
Yeah.
I could tell you, I just designed Dennis Schroeder's room from the Lakers.
Oh!
Yeah, I just finished it, actually.
No way. Kidding. Well, damn, man.
It was cool, bro.
We got to buy you dinner. So
totally custom.
Can you know? Tell us about
he said
like
you got to buy me dinner?
Yes,
in
dude.
Exchange for a room design?
Yes.
Well, you got to buy me a restaurant.
Like, we're for coming up. Well, first of all,
think I am,
no,
bro.
No, the way I think what about it is that he's sharing are? The information, first of all. And that is hype as fuck.
Oh, you mean buy me dinner as a congratulations?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll take that. I thought you meant buy you dinner so that I could do a room in exchange.
Yeah, that's what I thought you meant too. I'm like, dude, where are we eating?
Get the hell out of here.
Yeah,
do you not know me by now, bro? God damn, yeah, I'll buy you dinner for a room.
Yeah, no, that's
take
dope.
This dude to Fogo to chat.
If it ain't no
yeah,
or...
for a month straight. Every
yeah, I know,
day,
right?
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Tell him. Ever since that day.
Bro, and we'll the dinner
a,
menu.
We'll buy you a prepaid card.
Even if we
card.
Go out breakfast, you have to request the dinner menu.
Fucking hors d'oeuvres, dude.
We'll get you a prepaid card. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, there you go. I like that. No. It's you
no,
know.
Can you tell us like what one of your favorite details of his room was? Just out of curiosity.
The whole room, bro.
Really?
Yeah, you want to see what it looks like?
I actually do.
Yeah, I do.
Is this something we can share too?
I wouldn't share it. No.
Okay. Cool.
Until he does.
Should we wait? Should we just save it for after the podcast then?
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's save
yeah,
it
let's
for after.
It
yes.
Yeah.
All right. And
I'm down.
You know what? Actually, since we're gonna save it for after, should we just wrap it up right here?
There you go.
Same
feels
like a good cozy place.
Yeah.
Feels good to me.
Okay.
Vibes are good.
Kick me out.
All right. No. I will never. You know what? Now right, I'm gonna nurture you more.
Thank
dude.
You for joining us in the 2 a.m. podcast. Get out.
Yeah. Get out.